Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to my channel. This evening, I brought another story for us. And I want to say thank you for everyone that passed by on the last video. Thanks for everyone that watched. I was so impressed, happy. I got over 100 views in 24 hours. Thank you very much. I so much appreciate everyone that watched my video, everyone that liked the video, everyone that dropped a comment. Thank you very much. I also still want to beg us to please subscribe. If you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. If today is the first time you are passing by on my channel, kindly please subscribe to your babe's channel now. Abba. It is free. You don't pay for subscription. Subscription is 100% free. Just click on the subscription button and on the red notification button so that anytime I drop new video, you get notified. Okay? Today's story, I'm going back to Africa, Asia, Europe, and America. Okay, but before I continue again, kindly subscribe. It is subscription that will give me morale to do more. Kindly please subscribe to my channel. I beg you. Please don't mind this the lights on the video. Something is going on and coming up because I'm using the window light and then I'm using my small light, I say, but I can see that something is not very bright. So don't mind it. Just listen to the story. Okay. So after I made my last video that day, somebody just called me on my messenger because I think I dropped my Facebook address. Somebody just called me on my messenger and said, please, can I talk to you? I said, why not? This is what I love to do now. Just. So she started. She said she came to Europe when she was 15 years. And she met her husband, the father of her first child, when she was 18. They got married legally here in Europe. They got married legally. And then she had her first daughter for him when she was 19. And then they stayed together for 3 years. The man was a nice man. He was taking care of her. He bought her car. He wanted her to go back to school. But for her, she doesn't want to go to school because what she came to Europe to do is to look for money. The guy bought her car, made her comfortable, everything that she wanted, the man was giving to her. But you know now, she told me, she said, but I was not comfortable. I was not satisfied with everything the man was giving to me. I wanted a black man. A black man, no. In fact, not only black man, the black man that is from our own village, that is the black man she's looking for. So she was doing everything to make the man divorce her. You know, the man loved her so much, the man refused to divorce her. But she now told the man herself that she's not enjoying the relationship because in the other room, she said the man is zero. In the other room, you people understand now. That the man is zero and the man's thing is just small, that she was not enjoying anything from that aspect. So she needed to look for a man that is from a village, a black man that is from, you know, that can hammer the thing the way she wants it. So she told the man that she was not enjoying it and she wanted a divorce. Finally, the man got the divorce for her. But before she left the man made sure she had a red passport. The daughter had a red passport and the man bought the house where she's living for her in the daughter's name because the man so much loved her and he was thinking, she said the man told her that if she changed her mind again, he will still remarry her. That kind of man, it's got so. That he will still remarry her. So they divorced. She was so happy that now she can look for all the black guys that she wants. A year after the divorce, she met this black man from her village, Gongo, what she has been praying for. I think the girl is a lucky girl because this guy that she met again, a very nice guy. As in, as she told me, she said the guy is so nice to a fault that she began to ask, is this man really from Nigeria? And as in, is this man really from that village where she comes from? Because the guys from her village are not nice like that. She said the guy is so hardworking, and the guys from her village are not like that. So she was even scared that, is this man a real man? Is this man not pretending? But she married a man too, legally. She has a French passport. She married a man legally. And then after 1 year with the guy, she gave birth to a boy. But before she gave birth to that boy, after their marriage, the guy's younger brother came from Africa to live with them. That is where the story is starting from. The guy came to live with them after their marriage. And then the husband is somebody that is always at work. He works at night. And the younger brother is at home with the woman. You know? According to her, she said she could not even explain. One day like that, her husband went to work, and she was at home with her husband's younger brother. She just saw that in the morning, she saw that she and the husband's younger brother were on the bed together, naked. Just like that, though. The thing just, the guy just fly and come on top of her. And then, that was the beginning. She and her husband's brother started sleeping with each other. That was 1 year in their marriage. I'm sure this thing, the way she told me, she said after their marriage, I'm sure the marriage was not even up to 3 months before the guy came. And then the guy started shanking her. You know, understand now. Those people wake up from yonder, and I understand what the shanking means. The guy started shanking her. The husband was shanking her. Husband's brother was shanking her. And then she got pregnant. But you know now, there's one thing people used to say. A woman that is pregnant really knows who's the father of her child is. If he like, me three men, they sleep with her at the same time. She knows the one that is the father of her child. So, she got pregnant. She gave birth. But before she gave birth, she had already started arranging her husband's resident permit for him, you know. So, before she gave birth, she has done all the paper processing, and when she gave birth, the guy's paper came out. You know, he got his paper and everything. Then after she gave birth, she advised her husband to look for a house for the husband's younger brother, because she said she doesn't want to continue doing it again. So they got a house for the husband's younger brother. And then after 1 year, she gave birth to another baby again, a girl this time around. The husband brother did not do inside this woman. It was only the husband that did this one. It's only the husband. She was sure that it's only her husband that did this one. So the husband brother have been staying in this country now for like 4 years. He did aduro. Aduro through and for duro, you know, get paper. He did the other one, people we know well own. He didn't get. He tried to pay for somebody to do that igbeyawo. The thing no work. So one day, this younger brother came to visit this couple. That's the lady and her husband. So as they were talking, they were discussing about document that the guy says he's even tired. He cannot get his document. So the guy asked, thank God though, if not for my wife and this my first son that I have, I for not get paper. It was because of my wife that has French passport. And this my son, because the mother is French, he becomes French automatically. So I got my paper from there. That thing just rang in the boy's head. How will it be this boy that gave you resident permit? I am the original father of this boy. Something was ringing in the head. So that night when the guy left the house, the guy called the lady back. Babe, that's the way my brother talk, a ring for my head. That boy, now my boy, you know me, I know. See, now me get that boy. Me, I want to use the boy self collect paper. Me, I not go there for abroad for 5 years now. Me, I cannot get paper. Me, I want to use that boy self collect paper. Any way you want to do them, I'll go find money for this McDo work where they do. I'll go pay lawyer. I won't use my picking collect paper. He tell the lady like that. He put the lady in confusion. She became so confused in the house that the husband started noticing that something is wrong. And then the husband started noticing that his brother is always calling his wife. And anytime his brother called the wife, she became so panicked. She becomes so panicking, you know. She became, you know, anyone panicking. Me, the manager like that, you know. So the guy said, you know, the husband started trying to know what was going on, Along the line, now that this Koro thing can't happen. Before this Koro thing, the husband traveled to Nigeria. The husband is present in Nigeria now. He's blocked there because he went to Nigeria before the Koro, and when they blocked it, something, he couldn't come back. So he's in Nigeria now. So the guy kept coming home. Calling her that I won't call my brother for Africa. Tell her what happened between me and you. So my brother go feel no way go tell our parents for that place. Say, this child and my child. And I want you to collect paper too. You know? The girl is not even scared of the paper stuff. The girl is scared that this guy will scatter her marriage because the lady told me that this her husband is so sweet. And she said she's sure that that son belongs to the husband's younger brother. I mean, a woman know who sleep with him, and a woman know who get the belly. So she can't be middle of the Red Sea now. She doesn't know what to do. She's confused. She calls her. She says sometimes she pick her phone. She wants to tell her husband what's happened. She'll call the guy, and the guy will say, what? Why are you calling me? Anything happening? The guy is even scared whether she get corona, you know? Then the guy was now asking her, let my brother come and stay between the house before I come back. Before this corona thing will come back. But she cannot tell the husband what is going on. And now the younger brother is threatening to tell the brother that he is the owner of the boy. My people, what do you advise her to do? What is she going to do? How is she going to handle this matter? I'm putting this thing in you people's hand. Kindly advise her. Tell her what to do. Tell her how to go about it. Though me, you know, know me now, I would have given my own advice firstly. My advice to her was that, tell your husband. Because if you don't tell him, the brother will tell him. And according to her, where she comes from in Nigeria, it is a taboo for the same brother to sleep with one woman. So she's scared of what will happen in Africa, what will happen to her marriage here, because she knows here, the government here doesn't care whoever owns the child. It's for you, the mother, to say who the mother of the child is and everything like that. So now, she's begging me that she doesn't want to put this matter that she told me in the hands of those big YouTubers that is from her place. Because if she put it, some people will know that she's the one. So she's putting it in my own hand because she knows me, I'm a small YouTuber now. Just starting, you know. So she's putting it in my hand to tell my audience to please help her. She doesn't know what to do. She's sure the baby belongs to her husband's younger brother. And the child is a boy. And in her husband's place, the first son is like the person that has a boy child first is like a king. And this our husband is already seeing himself as a king because his first child is a boy. But now the child is not his own. So kindly help him, advise her. Tell her what to do. And then she'll be reading your comment. Kindly put your comment under the video in Facebook. In YouTube. Because I saw that so many people put their comments under the notification I put on my Facebook. Kindly put it here on YouTube so that she will read it, and then YouTube will see. Now help my ministry, now let my ministry go. Thank you very much for watching. Please kindly subscribe, invite your friends, share my video, help this channel to grow. Like and comment, negative, positive comment, just put anyone. Let me see what you think about this, my channel. Let me see what you think about me. And kindly subscribe, share. Thanks for watching. Thanks for always coming back. I love you all. Thank you. Bye-bye. See you soon. I'll bring another one because there's another one that is cooking that somebody just gave me, you know. Another story is cooking. Kindly subscribe. Subscribe now. When my subscription hits 100, there's a giveaway, a very big giveaway that's going to come when my subscription gets 100 subscribers. Kindly subscribe. I have giveaway when my subscribers get to 100. Thanks for watching. Share, and comment. Thanks. I love you. Bye.